The first time we noticed something was wrong with Ameera, I don't actually remember the actual date. I know that her dad died March 29, 2020 on her 10th birthday. And shortly after that, she started having tonic-clonic seizures. We just thought they were pseudo in nature, brought up emotionally because of the trauma that of losing her dad. It would happen and I would, you know, lay her on the sofa or on the bed and kind of just let it pass. Until one day she had like a 20-minute seizure and, you know, she had to be transferred to Westchester Medical.
We had to do a special kind of surgery called a stereo EEG, where we place EEG electrodes into the brain. Instead of just having them on the scalp, we actually place them deep into the brain. We're able to see where the seizures are starting from to within a few millimeters of their starting.
Well, we learned at Westchester Medical that apparently she was having seizures probably her whole life, and we didn't notice. She was having something called absence seizures. I was asked questions like, hey, you know, when she was a child, did she ever like walk away from you when you told her to get something and then she'll come back without having it? Do you ever notice her pause and blink rapidly?
We have a stimulator. It's kind of like a pacemaker for the brain called a responsive neurostimulator, or RNS. And this is a device that we actually put the battery itself into the skull and the electrodes into the brain and on the surface of the brain in the areas where the seizures are coming from, or in an area in the network of seizures where they're spreading. And then we can actually watch her EEG 24/7, meaning we can see exactly what activity is going on in her brain 24/7, all day, every day on this device. And this device can be programmed to stimulate when it sees her seizure.
She went from having hundreds of seizures a day to having 2.5 a month. So I don't feel this. This is real. This is live. This is data.
We're this way.
This is, here it is. Look at it in black and white. You know, this is the way. What I love about it is that it's really like personalized, individualized medicine, right? Like very personal to Ameera. I can tell you, if she slept that day, if she ate that day, you know, how much she drank, did she exercise that day? You know, we can correlate all the information and be like, ah, this makes sense, right? And then they can say, oh, okay, computer, when you see this, zap it away.
And if they can see a pattern on there that they can recognize, they can then train the device to fire every time it sees that pattern. And if it stimulates when it sees that, it can often stop the seizure from happening or prevent it from spreading throughout the patient's body. So it can really control seizures very well for a lot of patients when we don't have the option to actually take out the area that the seizures are starting.
Good boy.
She didn't have any negative side effect, none physically. I think for her, you know, emotionally, it was a roller coaster. You know, they had to shave a part of her head. She didn't go to school for a long time. Those things impacted her a little bit mentally.
She's attached to me.
But physically, she did well. You'll be able to do all the typical things that teenagers do that she wasn't able to do before.
Yeah, I love her.
I am like forever grateful and debt to these people, to Dr. Wolf, Patty, Dr. Mule, Maria Ferrer Hospital. I'm just super grateful that my daughter had this experience with the right doctors.